Она розовенькая,
симпатичная.
Why? What soap did you use?
By that I mean she is clean and untouched. Do I hear the phone ring?
Yes, I took down a number.
Who is Janet Watkins?
Department of Social Services. They want to take Grace into their infant care facility until they can find a proper foster home.
Did you tell her that Lieutenant Boswell is filing a waiver so that
yes,
we can keep her here?
That's why she called. The request was denied.
Why?
I don't know. You'll have to ask her that.
Did you tell her that we're going to fight her legally?
No.
Or did you tell her that we're trying to find Grace's mother?
What difference does it make? Obviously, her mother doesn't want her.
What did you tell her?
That I understood.
You understood what? That they're going to take her and put her in an institution until they can pay somebody to take her off their hands?
Michael, stop acting like this is something
you understand what this looks like? It looks like we don't know. We can't make up our minds whether we want to keep her.
What are you talking about? You don't even know what's on my mind. Do you? You never asked. You expect me to stay here on some permanent sojourn, away from home, playing maid to you and some child who likes me even less than you do.
All right. Number one, this is not about being liked. That is not why she's here.
And what makes you think you are the best thing in the world for that baby anyway?
Look, I never said...
You didn't just drop out of priesthood. You graduated to God.
Did I? Is that what it means when you're not afraid to be relied on?
Well, we have one of our best men heading up the investigation into Tennell's death. I just hope that his widow isn't wearing rose-colored glasses when it comes to the memory of her husband.
Well, I think Mrs. Tennell has a good awareness of her late husband's reputation.
All right. Excuse me. What is it, Michelle?
I know who you're with, Ethan. I am sorry to interrupt, but I wish to speak to Mr. Thacker.
And who are you?
My name is C.C. Capwell. I know you're representing Tennell's widow in the handling of the estate. Part of that estate is my company, and I want it back.
Mr. Capwell, my office is not a place for discussions pertaining to business.
It is for this one. You and I both know, Ethan, that he was a crook. Tennell was a thief responsible for people's deaths. And as a felon, he has no legal right to have taken my company.
Mr. Tennell is dead. And he had no criminal record. And the records that I have examined show that your company was first taken over by a gentleman named Robert Barr. Now, until Mr. Tennell's will is read, we have no idea even who's going to be in charge of Capwell Enterprises.
Mr. Thacker, I will not sit still for any legal maneuver.
Well, you know, the will is being read this afternoon in Las Vegas.
Good. I want to be there.
Mr. Thacker?
Yes, well, it's probably a very good idea since you've been named one of Mr. Tennell's beneficiaries.
What kind of perverse joke is this?
No joke at all, Mr. Capwell. The will is being read in Mrs. Tennell's home. And being the kind of understanding woman that she is, I'm sure that she would find no objection to your being there.
Kind, understanding woman. She must be a viper if she married Tennell, if she thinks she's going to hang on to my company, Mr. Thacker.
Mr. Capwell, I would like you to meet Mrs. Tennell.
I miss you, too. If all goes well, I should be home tonight.
Great. Mason, listen, honey, I'm sorry I have to go because this child welfare agency is hassling Michael over the baby he's taking care of. I promise that I'd give him a hand. Good luck today. I love you. Mason.
What?
I said I love you.
Oh, I love you too.
How did you get in here?
Room service. So, is this the right thing for a funeral?
Absolutely. The perfect balance between despair and decolletage.
Well, how about zipping me up? Or down. Whichever.
Sasha, I thought I made everything clear in that department. Just because the two of us checked into the same hotel together doesn't mean...
I know what it doesn't mean, Mason, so you can just relax. I was just hoping that your sense of humor hadn't gone down the same drain with your sense of adventure.
I was merely pointing out that the clearer it is between
us, that... I know, clear. You're not going to leave Julia. So, how much time do we have?
Well, it's still a few hours until the funeral.
You know, it just seems odd to me that he's dead, Mason. I know that a lot of people hated him and that he was involved in something very dangerous, but to me, he just seemed invincible.
All it took was a bullet to disprove that theory, and it didn't come a moment too soon, either.
I just hope he doesn't let me down in death the way he did in life.
Sasha, I'm not exactly sure what you're expecting to happen today,
I'm expecting that after the reading of this will, I will never have to depend on a man for anything again.
Well, you are certainly more confident of inheriting Tanel's wealth than you were yesterday. But have you talked to someone who knows something about the will?
I wouldn't keep anything from you, Mason.
Well, then why the sudden optimism?
I don't know. Maybe it's just because I'm in Las Vegas. And I feel that I'm overdue for some good luck.
Vegas. Dante, listen to me. You just make the arrangements. I'll explain it later. I'm at the bar. Yeah, I got a tip. I'm hoping it'll pay off. So you just get in touch. Well, look who just came back. Yeah, I gotta tell you, Craig, you're about the last guy I expected to see around here again. Well, you got a death wish, you just criminally doomed. Both, I guess, huh?
Tanel's dead, and what the hell do you want with me, Castillo?
I want you to be dead, too. I always have. Even before you showed your true colors with the attempted murders and the kidnappings and the extortion. I just never did like you much, Craig. Not a bit.
You're not gonna kill me.
No?
There's too many witnesses.
You think these guys are gonna talk to the police about it?
You won't.
Yeah, maybe you're right. Maybe I won't kill you. Maybe I'll just make you wish I had. How you talking to me? Who murdered Tanel?
The wind is out of the south.
What does that mean?
She used to say she'd see us when the wind was out of the south.
Who?
Someone we both knew a long time ago. Someone who I'm sure will never show up here.
Well, I'm not so sure.
Look, I thought you guys were going to play football all day. Why aren't you outside?
We're going to ride our bikes down to the beach. Football's more fun in the sand.
Yeah, Brandon, why don't you go and get your jacket on? We'll go.
Okay, I'll be right back.
Would you please put it down?
Wait a second, the world's greatest DA? I wonder who that's for.
It's just my way of thanking Ethan for his help.
Oh, sure.
It is. I don't know what I would have done without him when Santana took Brandon.
Oh, come on, Gina. You've been trying to jump his bones for weeks.
I have not. He's a married man.
I know. And he's married to Laura. You're just acting like you used to in high school. You were always after her boyfriends.
Well, at least I managed to graduate.
What the hell does that have to do with anything, huh, Gina?
I'm sorry. I get a little touchy when people jump to conclusions. Ethan and I are friends. That's it.
I'm sorry, but I don't buy it.
It's the truth. We're friends and nothing more.
Gina, I'm your brother. I know you. When you want something or someone, you get it. Poor Ethan Asher doesn't have a chance.
Mrs. Donnell, I'm very glad to get a chance to meet you. I owe you an apology if anything I have said might have offended you and caused you pain in this time of grief.
Yes. Voice there now? All right, I'm on my way. I'm sorry, but an emergency's come up. Mrs. Tunnell, as I told your attorney, we have our best man trying to find out who killed your husband. If you'll excuse me.
Yes. Well, it seems our business here is concluded, Mrs. Tunnell.
No, it is not.
Mr. Capwell, it hardly seems this is the right time to discuss
it. I understand this might not be the perfect time to discuss this. I'm counting on the compassion of Mrs. Tunnell. You see, your husband helped to engineer the takeover of my company, Capital Enterprises. To him, it was just another acquisition. To me and my family, it was something far greater than that. It represented my life's work. Now, how I managed to get sloppy enough in the first place to let him take it over, I don't know. It's history. But right now, I want it back. I'm sure that the last thing that you want staring you in the face is running a major corporation. And I'm sure that we could find some suitable financial means that would be satisfactory to both of us. You see, I'm not talking about money. That doesn't interest me right now. What does is the Capwell name and the family working together to create something they can be proud of. Where the hell is she going?
She's going back to Las Vegas. It seems that she doesn't feel this is an appropriate time to discuss
when business. The hell are we going to discuss it?
Soon, Mr. Capwell. I will see you at the reading of the will.
Thacker. Just what did Mrs. Tunnell really say?
I believe her exact words were, my husband's body isn't even cold yet, and the old goat is trying to pull a fast one. Tell him to buzz off. Good day, Mr. Capwell.
The rules child welfare has set forward are quite clear, Mrs. Capwell.
We're not talking about rules, Mrs. Watkins. We're talking about a baby girl.
And since that baby has been abandoned, it is my responsibility to place her in a foster home.
I see. Do you have any papers on the foster parents?
Actually, things are running a bit tight at the moment.
Maybe you could explain to me exactly what that means.
That merely means that the child would be placed in a county facility until foster parents are available.
And at what point in time do you expect that to happen?
I'm not psychic, Mrs. Capwell.
I'm afraid you're not very compassionate either. I don't know why you would want to take Grace away from two parents who are being very warm and affectionate to put her in a county facility where it is clear that the staff doesn't have time to take care of these children and give them the care that they need.
I'm trying to do my job.
Then will you tell me as a professional, please, or give me your estimate as to how long it will take Grace to be put into a foster family? 6 months, a year,
I'll
perhaps,
admit
maybe 2 years.
There is a backlog.
And insufficient funds, if I read the county auditor's report correctly. Mrs. Watkins, you aren't going to find two people who care more about this child than Michael and Greta.
As an attorney, your argument is well thought out, Mrs. Capwell, but an unwed couple shacked up together over a saloon is hardly an ideal alternative.
Miss Watkins, now, there is nothing morally objectionable about Greta's relationship with me.
These two individuals have impeccable character references. Greta is an OB nurse. Michael is running a community center, which is a totally charitable institution.
Well, I also think that you're operating under the false assumption that we want to keep Grace.
What exactly do you want, Mr. Conway?
What we want to do is find this baby's mother and give her back to her, encourage her to be her mother.
I think that the worst thing for this baby would be to be reunited with a woman who abandoned her.
Look, Grace's mother, all right, was young. She was scared to death because she didn't think that she could support her baby. But the fact of the matter is, there is help available. And when she knows there is help...
Mr. Donnelly, I came into this job with the same kind of optimism you seem to have now. When it's been shot down often enough, you tend to realize and understand why certain rules were made.
Doesn't the baby deserve a little optimism?
You'll never find the mother. And if you do, you'll realize that she's too irresponsible to care for an infant. But since there really isn't room in any foster home for the child, I'll recommend that she remain with you for 2 more weeks.
Thank you, Miss Watkins.
At the end of the 2 weeks, there will be a hearing to decide where the child shall reside from that point on.
We'll have to go to court?
If you wanted to attempt to get custody of Grace, yes, but you wouldn't stand a chance. However, she will remain with you until that time.
I don't know who killed Tennelle.
How did I know you were going to say that?
Look, I swear it, all right? Look, I knew there was going to be a hit, but I have no idea who ordered it. Tennelle was starting to lose it, so I just cut out.
Yeah. It's just not good enough, Craig. You see, I need a name. A name.
You want a name? Ask your wife's boyfriend. He's the one who hates Tennelle.
The thing is, I don't really want to ask my wife's boyfriend.
Yeah, I don't really want to ask. I want a name. I don't want to hear his name. I want another name. And you've got about 5 seconds to live if you want to live, man. So give me the man's name.
Cruz. I said let him go.
Hell, Ethan.
Lock this bastard up. This guy's crazy, man. He's trying to kill me.
Get him out of here.
He's a nut. Did you see that?
Well, are you all right?
I'm fine.
Good.
What were you doing, just you and the boys in the neighborhood?
No, one of our men happened to see Hunt come in here.
Uh-huh. One of the men you had following me?
Cruz, you were planning to bring him in, weren't you?
Of course I was, Ethan. It was the first thing I was going to do, is bring him in.
Good. You know, maybe we should put Boswell on this case with you or, form a task force.
No, that's not the deal. That was not the deal. This is my case. You give it to me. So I will run it however I damn well please. If you don't mind, I'm busy doing that. So it's great seeing you.
Our plane leaves for Vegas in 30 minutes.
What about the funeral?
It wasn't easy, but I got us in.
Good.
You know, the camera's in the car. When are you going to tell me what's going on?
Well, just because Tonell is dead, I don't think that means that he can't tell us who killed him. Come on.
Oh, hi.
Gina.
I love your new desk. When did you get it?
Well, it must have come about 5 minutes ago.
Well, it really is beautiful.
I'll expect to see this in the governor's office within 5 years. Just like my father, to put on the pressure.
Was this your father's desk?
I used to hide under this when he was governor.
Well, I think it's nice he has so much confidence in you. I do, too.
Well, now, what is this?
Well, I feel kind of silly about this. Yeah? I mean, I'm having a hard time giving it to you after you've gotten this beautiful desk.
Oh, no, this is great. Let's see. Thank you.
It's true, you know.
Well, I'm not so sure it is, but I appreciate the sentiment.
Look, who would have helped me find Brandon the way that you did?
Well, you see, I'm not so sure that's due to being the world's greatest DA. It's more due to being a friend. You know how much I care about Brandon.
Brandon cares about you, too. Thank you for being so supportive.
Well, is that what friends are for?
Yeah, but you were more than a friend. You were there when I needed somebody to talk to. I knew that no matter how bad things got, I could turn to you and that you'd really care about me.
I did care. I do care. So, how's Brandon doing?
Okay. I think he's come out of this with fewer scars than I have. I sat myself down and I said, you've got to take a look at how you're treating him.
Oh, you've done a great job with Brandon.
Sometimes. But I put a lot of pressure on him. I love him. And I know he loves me, but we don't exactly have the traditional mother-son relationship.
Oh, and what is a traditional mother-son relationship?
I don't know. Something in between the Waltons and Psycho. What's so funny?
I like your perspective on life.
You do, huh?
Yes, I do. And Brandon is very lucky to have you. And I know he's smart enough to know it.
Raining hard out there?
Yes, it is.
Laura, why don't you take this off? You'd be more comfortable.
No, I'm fine.
Well, I guess I better get going. I've got to pick up Brandon and Mac. I think they probably got caught in the downpour. But I'm glad to see you, Laura. I'm glad you're here.
Are you?
Yes, I'd like to invite you and Ethan to dinner tomorrow night. Just a small way of saying thank you for everything you did to help me find Brandon.
Dinner, that sounds great.
Well, it does sound great, Gina, but I'm afraid we already have a commitment.
What?
Well, I promised Michael that we'd go down to the community center and help him with his drive for the children's toys campaign, and we're making a large contribution. It wouldn't hurt your career to get that in the society pages. Maybe we can do it another time, Gina, huh?
Sure, whenever.
Well, I don't see why we can't make dinner tomorrow night.
Ethan, I just told you.
Well, why don't we do both? I mean, we can go to the community center, then we can go to Gina's for dinner.
All right, that sounds great. I'll tell you what, Laura, I'll call you tomorrow about the details. See you later.
Bye-bye.
I was just kind of hoping we'd have some time alone tomorrow night.
Well, we're alone now. So what do you have in your basket, Goldilocks?
Well, you big bad bear, I thought I'd bring some lunch to celebrate your father's gift, and I thought we also would like to talk about doing a little redecorating to go with the new desk.
Oh, I see. So you knew about this.
He called me, and I told him I thought it was a wonderful idea.
Well, as if there's any way we could have stopped him.
He's interested in your career, sweetheart, and he thinks this is only a first step, and I agree with him.
Well, Laura, if we're going to have lunch, why don't you take off that overcoat?
Why, Mr. District Attorney, I thought you'd just never ask.
Laura, do you realize that my secretary can walk in here at any moment?
No.
No, I sent her on a long lunch.
You did.
And then I made sure that the door would lock when Gina left. So I'm afraid, Mr. Asher, we're all alone. So what do you say we break in this desk properly?
Where's Brandon?
Are you kidding? He's outside.
That downpour?
He loves the rainstorm. He's playing football on the beach with some guys. He's having a great time.
You know, he's going to think his Uncle Mac is an old fuddy-duddy because I came in out of the rain.
He's going to think his Uncle Mac is a terrific guy, and I agree with him. I didn't have time to wrap it.
What's this for?
For helping Mason and me.
Yeah, I didn't do it for this.
I know you didn't, but we appreciate it anyway.
Thank you.
You're welcome. It's a first original edition. I'm sorry, I hope you haven't read all of them.
No. I do know that Hemingway is a great writer, though.
Yeah, I love him. In spite of his macho images.
In our time.
It's a collection of some early stories. It's about man and nature kind of things. I thought you'd like it. It's really great.
No one's ever given me a book before.
They haven't? Oh. I didn't know what to get you. I thought...
Look, what I mean is... it was really nice of you to buy me this.
Well, why not?
Well, because women have usually given me, like, a tie, shirt.
A Porsche.
This is better than a Porsche.
Good. I'm glad. Now, I made tea. It's herbal, like you like. It's got things floating around in it. I followed the directions.
Yeah. Look, I'm sorry we barged in on you like this.
Well, I'm glad you did.
So am I.
We shall miss his companionship, his loyalty, and his wisdom. To Anthony Tennell.
I should have left when that Harridan slapped me.
Now, you've heard the saying about turning the other cheek. We need you here for the reading of the will. She may have drenched Tennell's body in crocodile tears, but you could have the last laugh.
Would you look at these people? You'd think that Anthony was a hero rather than a murderer.
Well, he was a hero to them. He lined their pockets with money. I don't believe you just walked in. Yes, I do.
Sasha, Mason.
Hello, Mr. Capwell.
Do we owe the pleasure of your company, Dad?
I'm here for the reading of the will. I'm one of Tonell's beneficiaries.
Now I've heard everything.
Well, Anthony had a very perverse view of life. Why shouldn't he look at death the same way?
Any leaks about what might be in the will?
Nothing so far.
I couldn't help fantasizing on the way over here that Tennell willed Capwell Enterprises back to me as a slap in the face to Barr.
That would be a very expensive slap in the face.
Mm. Champagne, sir?
No, thanks. How's it going?
Not bad. I got pictures of everyone here. As a matter of fact, here come some familiar faces right now. Ruse, I'm a little surprised to see you here.
I'm investigating Mr. Tennell's murder.
Don't you think you should have been with the kids, Eden? The Cruz, if you don't talk to her, how do you expect...
Mr. C, please. Some other time.
For those of you concerned, after the memorial service for Mr. Tennell, we'll be conducting a reading of the will.
What is this?
Well, I don't believe that you've been invited to our little gathering.
I regret that I had to invite myself, but I do need to speak with the lady of the house.
I don't believe that's going to be possible.
I think you can make it possible. Why don't you do it right now, in fact?
This way, please. Difficult time this is, Mrs. Tunnell. But Mr. Castillo needs to ask you some questions about your husband's death.
All right. Mrs. Tunnell, where were you the night of your husband's death?
She was right here.
Did Mr. Tunnell have any enemies that she knew of?
Only Robert Barr.
I realize this is a sensitive time, but I do need to ask you about the state of your marriage. I have reason to believe it was under some kind of strain, that there was a conflict.
Mr. Castillo, please.
Samantha with her dad?
No, she's at a birthday party. She has a friend that she met at the park.
Mason at work?
If you call being in Vegas work.
Vegas?
Yeah, he's there representing Sasha while they read Tunnell's will.
When's he coming back?
I think they were hoping to come back tonight.
I thought that Sasha would go someplace else after all the trouble she's been through here.
I'm not really sure what she's going to do, but she's going to stay here until she figures that out.
Here.
Sure. Why not? We have room. Why?
No reason.
Hello, Gina. Brandon called. I know. I didn't hear him come ask you to pick him up.
Well, I didn't want him to have to walk home in the rain. Where is he?
He's out playing football. I'll get him.
How cozy, a nice warm fire.
I was just drying off.
Come on, level with me. What's going on between you and Julia?
We weren't doing anything, Gina.
How do you think Mason would react if he came in here and saw the two of you?
I'm telling you, we weren't doing anything.
Nice cozy fire. Two for tea for two.
You know, this is double standard. You get so damn sensitive when I mention one word about Ethan Asher, and here you are.
I'm not after Ethan Asher.
See what I mean?
Thank you.
Tennell regarding your inquiry. After reviewing your prenuptial agreement, I'd have to say it would be difficult to fight in court. If you divorce Mr. Tennell, your settlement will be limited to $50,000. Of course, you would inherit a far greater amount if he were to die. I believe, therefore, the prudent financial course would be to remain married. Sincerely, G. Emmett Attorney.
What are you doing here?
I came in through the window. You can dump the waiter routine. We're out of here.
I thought you had to find...
I got everything I need right here.
Yeah, except a search warrant. What happened to police procedure?
Is that really you talking? Let's get out of here.
You are a wicked woman.
Thank you. Now, we should get down to work.
I don't think I have the energy to work.
Well, you've got to pick out a carpet and new drapes to go with your new desk and the chairs I ordered.
You ordered new chairs?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, you'll love them. They're French, and I got a couple of tables that are covered with marble.
Laura, yeah, we're going to go broke redecorating my office.
Oh, you have to project the right kind of image.
I do?
Hmm.
I mean, you walk around town stark naked with nothing on except an overcoat. And I have to project the right image.
Well, the raincoat is fine for the image, sweetheart, and you're the only one who knows that there's nothing under it.
Well, these things are too expensive.
We're not going to run out of money. And even if we do, we can always fall back on your trust fund.
Damn it, Laura, we're not going to use that money. Now, we've always lived off of our income, and that's the way it's going to stay. I don't plan to take any of the money out of the gift from my grandfather.
I'm sorry.
Yeah.
I forgot how strongly you felt about this.
I do feel strongly about it.
I know. Maybe we just got back to the decorating too soon, huh?
What happened?
Oh, gee, I guess we weren't too careful. This doesn't matter.
It does matter.
She's really beautiful.
You didn't think so at 3 o'clock in the morning when she was crying.
I know.
2 weeks, that's 14 days, 336 colic-filled hours.
I know. I was sort of getting used to the idea of all of us being here.
Me too. After all, you're the only person that can make me laugh at 3 o'clock in the morning.
Thanks. I think. Don't you think it's strange how this whole thing just happened?
I don't think we should think at all.
I just meant that the baby came into our lives and... Michael, I thought we were just going to be friends and not complicate things.
Well, we don't have to complicate it. We don't even have to analyze it. We could just let it happen.
According to Mr. Tennell's instructions, all the beneficiaries need to be present for the reading of the will. Now, I can see that we have a problem here. Mr. Robert Barr is one of the beneficiaries, and unfortunately, he's still in the hospital in Santa Barbara.
Yes.
I think that's a good suggestion, Mrs. Tennell. Since we can't read the will without Mr. Barr present... We will reschedule the reading of the will for 2 weeks from today. In the event that Mr. Barr is still in the hospital, perhaps we can have the reading of the will there. I'm sorry that you've all wasted a trip.
Nah.
What?
No, you're not going to drink that.
Gina, would you please? What's the matter with you?
You know.
No.
I don't know anything.
Don't you feel it?
Feel what?
$40, lady.
Did you hear that?
No.
Oh. Well, there they are, my beautiful children. Only no one would believe it. They look like my brother and sister.
Hey, lady.
Matt, give this scrubby man $40, huh?
Sure, Mom.
Take care of Mr. Barr.
These two guys are big-time mobsters. This guy is heavy into munition smuggling. Any one of these guys could have ordered a hit on Tunnell.
I don't think so. I think it was the widow. She knew about Tunnell's mistress. She knew if she divorced him, she wouldn't get a dime. So she had him killed. You mix betrayal on top of greed, you got a powerful motive for murder.
Yeah. Hi, Eden. Yeah, he's right here. Sorry, Eden. You know, I guess I was wrong. You just missed him. Yeah. Bye.